Hello and welcome, my Libra Collective Sun, Moon, Rising Sign. Welcome to your work, career, vocation read for October and November 2020. I am your reader, Marcangela Lyons Mal for short. Professional witch, professional intuitive, president of Drawing the Circle Productions. The Archangel of Lyons, Marcangela Lyons. But you can call me Mal. Hi. How are you doing? Really enjoying doing these work, career, vocation reads, right? Different from all the twin flame soulmate drama, right? So my subscribers, welcome. And thank you so very much for your continued love and support. Mari, if you're out there, hey girl, hey. my Libras. I have Venus and Mercury conjunct in Libra, but we're not doing those. We're only doing Sun, Moon, and Rising for these reads. So thank you so much for your love and your support on my YouTube journey, doing this from my phone, like the majority of readers do, uploading it directly to YouTube this way. It's learning the editing process. It's just another step. Now I have three different ways to do these videos, and finding the creativity and all of that. And I couldn't do that without your likes, your subscribes, your comments, right? Helping my channel grow slow and steady, winning the race, shooting for 30,000 subscribers so that I can have the membership thing, so that I can do, you know, the members live chats, right? No one else can see it. We pretty much say whatever we want. They're not monetized because they're in a private thing. So you pay one thing per month, plus I'll be able to put the extended readings here as well as on Vimeo.com. You get to pay one price here instead of buying them individually on Vimeo. And I love Vimeo.com. They've really been a big part of my career for a while. So this is just, you know, learning and balancing new platforms and integrating them little by little. So if you're new to my channel, please do consider liking, subscribing, hitting the notification bell, commenting, what will this reading mean to you? I'll reiterate that again at the end, because I always do. Otherwise, let's get down to business. We're doing 9 cards, 3 Caroline Mace archetypes cards, 3 Daughters of the Moon tarot, and 3 Mythic tarot to look at the soul power that you are incorporating, alchemizing from lead to gold in yourself, within another, within a situation, in terms of your work, your career, your vocation, what's going on inside of you, what's going on outside of you. I do these readings for myself pretty much all the time, although I use different decks. This is the ones they told me to use this time. Work, career, and vocation are not the same thing. They're connected. The last reading, Virgo, it's like the difference between a thumb, a middle finger, and a pinky. They serve different functions. They do different things, but they're all fingers, right? So it's sort of like your service to the world, your life purpose in 3 levels of power. The first level of power is the physical, the literal level of power, the physical world. That's your work, what you do to survive, to pay the bills, if that's how you do it. Career, first level of power, lower 3 chakras, work, right? Interacting with the physical world and the people within it. The second level of power, career, heart, throat, third eye, and crown, emotional thirst and mental hunger, right? Your career, your passion, like what it is that is of service to yourself in this world, right? The personal level of power, the interior world, the psychological world. Your vocation is your spiritual calling, 8th chakra, right? The spiritual part of all of this, right? Like the larger purpose of your life, if you will. And by the way, 3 levels of power I learned from Caroline Mace. If you can find the audio that she did, it was a long time ago. It was back in the 90s, I think. Truly genius work, just changed everything. That's why I call my work magic, miracles, and mysticism, because of the 3 levels of power. By the way, I'm a Virgo, yeah, but my work is administration. I don't get paid for that. I am the president of the company, right? So all that busy work, communications and setting things up and the lighting and all that stuff, that's all the producer, the director, the president and me. But I make my money through my career, my love, my passion, teaching, reading, and counseling, right? So it's sort of like artist, teacher, and healer all together. You with me? And my vocation is as a mystic, obviously. So let's see what we got, shall we? This is a general read. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Check your other signs, because your sun is going to get different than your moon if you know all that. Otherwise, focus on your breath. Stay in the present moment. I will do the same to get you clarity, guidance, and grace. I think that's enough exposition, don't you? Breathe. And so we begin. All the decks that I read are in the description box at the bottom. Other cool links you might want to check out as we go. That will evolve for these readings as we go. I'm going to do these once a month, even though it's for October, November. So let us do this. my collective pantheons of angels, goddesses, gods, masters, and the higher selves of all involved, I need three cards for the Libra Collective. Sun, Moon, Rising. Sun, Moon, Rising signs in their work, career, vocation, October and November 2020, please. What is the soul power that they are dealing with within themselves? The archetype, the soul power being alchemized from lead to gold within themselves, within another, or within a situation or any combination or all of that in terms of their work, October, November 2020, please. The same thing in terms of their career, their interior world, their personal world. Just one card, please, for the Libra Collective, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign, dominant soul power, again, their own, someone else's, or a situation, but dealing with their internal world, heart, third eye, and crown in terms of their career. And please, for their vocation, eighth chakra, their spiritual calling, what is the dominant archetype soul power being developed there, their own, someone else's, or a situation, or any of that, all of that, pieces of it. Remember, archetypes are triggery, the shadow and the light, right? The shadow is what you don't want to look at, what you don't want to acknowledge, or you don't want anybody else to know about, right? You keep it hidden. The light is what you're shooting for, because even your work career and your vocation are about the evolution of the soul. It's all written into the script before you come in, right? Lots of quantum variation. Well, here we go, my Libras. You've got the mother archetype in terms of work. You might very well be a working mother. Now, it's gender neutral how it manifests, but it is a feminine family archetype, right? And if you like, of the great trine, the great triune maiden, mother, and crone, right? The shadow attribute, smothering or abandoning children, instilling guilt in children for becoming independent. Now, I do write down who gets what where for the titles here, and this is also in Cancer. Cancer also has the mother in the work position, so if you have any planets in Cancer, you might want to check that. Now, this does not have to be literal children. The brain children, right? Creative children, projects, right? So that thing of, you know, are you smothering? You know what it means to smother a project. It's too much busy work, not enough rest, not enough integration, right? Or abandoning, right? The projects, instilling guilt in children for becoming independent. I don't know how that works into this, but if it hits, it makes sense to you, it makes sense to you. The light attribute here, nurturance, patience, unconditional love, joy in giving birth to life. So whether this is you, there's some creative process here in the physical world. Something might be getting ready to be born, right? You conceive, you gestate, you labor, and you create, right? You well, it's all creativity, but you release it into the world and it takes on a life of its own little by little by little. Obviously not day one, right? Like a new business or something like that. So that is either the situation, you, someone you are dealing with, but all in your physical work world. Survival stuff, survival intuition. For interesting, for your career, you've got the card of the student, which is a really good card to get in terms of the interior, because then you can use my favorite code word, learning curve. Oh my God, you think that this YouTube journey from, I was born in 1968. We were still on analog, right? Digital came in the 70s, digital watch. I mean, it existed before, obviously, but not to the everyday man, right? To the everyday person. So this has all been a great learning for me, this journey. I get this, right? Your career should be a process of study, of learning, of growth. The shadow attribute, arrogance in the pursuit of destructive knowledge. Well, it depends on what your career drives are. Crush the opponents, right? Crush the competition. Unwillingness to translate knowledge into action. And I got to say, that is a trap. That is a trap. It's a necessary trap when we all fall into. So you get the knowledge of how to do it, but you don't act on it, right? It's like knowledge for knowledge's sake. It's never put into action to where it can become wisdom. Knowledge plus experience equals wisdom. The light attribute, though, humility and devotion to knowledge. The grace of humility is everything to me. It is my saving grace. When my book Words of Grace comes out next year, maybe by the end of this year, I doubt it though, for Kindle, which that's a project that's gestating, so to speak, right now for me. And openness to lifelong learning. It's like you really can have that grace of saying, I know that I don't know, but I'm willing to be shown. I'm willing to be shown what I need. I'm willing. Like humility doesn't mean, oh, poor me. It's pity. The grace of humility is the maiden grace, I call it, right? Because a maiden with, regardless of gender, a virgin, if you will, has that, okay, I don't know, but I'm willing to be shown. I'm willing to do this. Teach me. I'm willing to learn. So openness to lifelong knowledge is beautiful. And you guys are air signs, so that would make sense. A lot of thinking, a lot of studying, a lot of learning going on. Now, here's going to be the tricky one for you. You got the bully in your vocation. So your own inner fears might be bullying you, and there is spiritual growth there for you. There's spiritual growth on all three levels of power. They're all fingers of the same hand, right? They all influence each other. And if you think of the chakra flow from eighth down to root, that process of manifestation, then it's saying there's really something here in your spiritual calling, your symbolic level of power, that it doesn't necessarily mean you are a bully. Maybe you are dealing with a bully, but the situation itself might be doing that. So the shadow here conceals deep fears behind verbal or physical abuse. So there's deep fear, regardless, because fears are mentioned up here as well. So what makes somebody bully someone when they're afraid? But this feels like almost an existential kind of bullying about life purpose or something like that. You're calling. Sorry, I had a glitch there. I caught it. Where my life should be this, it should be that, and this one's doing that one. And so sort of bullying yourself, and that's what the light attribute is about, highlights your tendency to intimidate others. I intimidate others. I don't even realize I do it. And then I see what I look like. Helps you confront the inner fears that bully you. Definitely part of a spiritual process of alchemy here. So we are off to a really, really interesting start. Digging it. There's definitely an element of air here, even with the cloud blowing hot air here. So remember, these can be you, internal powers you're dealing with, obviously within yourself, soul powers, someone else, or a situation, or maybe all of that. Sometimes you get that mirror effect where it's all the same thing being reflected. So, daughters of the moon, let's see what's going on inside. Breathe. My goddesses of Libra, Aphrodite, please. The divine feminine, I need three cards in clarity for this Libra collective, sun, moon, rising sign in their work, career, vocation. We've got the mother archetype in their level of work. What's going on inside of them face down? What's their yin? What's going inside of them for their career involving the student archetype? What's going on there inside and for their vocation with the bully card? What's going on? We've got the mother, physical, literal world, the work. With Ixchel, the Aquarian, now this can mean so many different things. Can it be someone in your life that's affecting you in the inside? Possibly. But I find when Zodiac cards come up in the Divine Feminine position of things, this is about the 11th house energy, right? So you got this mother energy, but one that might be a little radical, might be like the Aquarians are the rebels of the Zodiac. Ixchel flies in the eagle. She's the eagle woman. Technically, the albatross flies highest, sees furthest, but who wants to call that, right? It's like the eagle flies highest, sees the largest picture. So this can very much be a humanitarian thing, a friendly thing, a thinking outside of the box, a seeing the larger picture here while something is gestating. Now, of course, like I said, if you're a literal mother, like, and I'm talking a female with children mother, then this can absolutely speak about higher vision for your work. You might be receiving larger picture flashes. GPS view, right? But there's great friendliness in here. And I get the humanitarian, egalitarian, not just all, can't we all get along, but we're all in this together and there's new technology, right? So it feels like it's gestating inside of you, whether you are a literal mother, a female or a male, right? It feels like that there may very well be inspired ideas within you that are taking shape and form more in the internal world, right? So let's look, because none of that speaks immediate action to me, except the action of a mother, right? Having to care for others, although the caretaker is a different archetype. Let's keep going. In your personal world, your career, you've got the student with another court card, and not just another court card, a fixed earth. So you got fixed air and fixed earth. So if you think of fixed earth, air as the stratosphere, seeing things from that perspective, right? Or maybe learning things, broadening your worldview about something, right? About technology, about whatever. But with the student with Taurus, this is about you really learning your life values. If these cards had shown up in the Mythic Tarot, I would see these more as external people. External people may be inspiring or triggering things. But second house, like your prosperity, your wealth, your stability, the things that you really value in your life, not just the physical, tangible, like honesty and loyalty and truth. These things, you are learning lessons inside of yourself about. Be the student. You might be getting an upgrade in these things and have to learn new levels of it, right? Because what is important to me now at 52 is very different than what was important to me at 29 when I started drawing the circle productions. It just, it grows and evolves. But my core life values are the same, right? Although evolved, right? The core is there. Honesty is way more important to me than money. Integrity is way, way. At this point, after what I've been through, oh girl, please just don't lie to me. with this bully archetype, in your vocation with Three of Pentacles. This card just came up for the Virgo read. It's one of my favorite cards in this deck. This is really about molding the clay and about something physical. It is an earth card. You have two earth cards here out of three for the interior world. So inside there is inner work going on, right? Something about the physical world, but something that you might be bullied about. I just, last night we live streamed, go find it, Amplifying Abundance. It was brilliant. It was an hour and 45 minutes because I started doing reads at the end and people were throwing money at me to pull three cards. So I did. And I had a field day. So you can skip that part. I'll be doing more of that too. Had a meeting today with Mal Flanders, if you've been watching the live streams, friend of ours here on YouTube, about doing more live streams, some meditation-based, some reading-based. We're going to figure all that out because they're my she's one of my two moderators with her daughter, Meow Meow Dollface, right? So there are plans in play here, but are they intimidating you, right? You've got these kind of like things and formulations going on, molding that clay, but there is a bullying thing here. Now, look, if you're starting something completely new, know that there the solid foundation or beginning foundation that you seek is in the eighth chakra. It's going to make its way down into physical form. But that's why you have to really look at your values, your integrity. Yes, of course, you know, people say, oh, it's money and abundance and prosperity. Yes, in terms of physicality, but think fixed earth, those values inside of you that are like family, love, right? These values, right? Interesting. Interesting. I really, really feel like there's a challenge here for you that you're growing, but but just like in the schoolyard, we got a student and a bully, but they're both you, or if there is somebody else or a situation that is bullying you, right? Like you might be getting a real inspiration for a career move or a change in work or whatever in terms of your spiritual life, and it scares you. Well, what if I'm not good enough? What if it's 2020, right? You'd be bullied by the market. Oh, bully market. That's not what I meant, but you know what I mean. Or you don't. All right, my Libras, let's get your last three cards down. So that's the internal, right? So you got the soul power, the eighth chakra with the archetypes. You got heart, throat, third eye, and crown. Three levels of power with the daughters of the moon. Let's get you the external, the yang, the masculine. Please, a nice deep breath. My gods of Libra, Eros in particular, please, son of Aphrodite, you work. God, you work, right? You are one of those gods that are always sending on missions, shooting people with gold and or lead arrows. Please, can we have three cards in clarity for this Libra collective sun, moon, rising sign in their work, career, vocation, October, November, 2020, please. You want to kiss my neck? You kiss my neck all you want. You're a god. I love him. He's so cute. Please. We've got the mother archetype with the crown of blades, Aquarius, Ixchel on the inner. Can we have what's going on for them on the outer? Their career. We've got the student archetype with the Taurus card, the Mother of Pentacles, the Great Corn Mother, what's going on in the outside there. And in their vocation, they've got the Bully archetype with the Clay Woman, Three of You see, that's where the block is. That's where there's a conflict there. Eighth chakra stuff, which you're going to go through. It's part of the divine plan, but you've got your fingers in the clay. So please, my gods, what's going on the outside there? See, like at this point, my senses are so honed that particularly those cards usually flow together that when they jam like that, it's like, oh, that's where the issue is. So in terms of your work again, Mother Archetype, the Aquarian card, this would be Queen of Swords if you want to go there, if you want me to translate that fixed air. On the outside, there's the Tower. There's the Tower. Now the Tower, yes, can mean destruction, but it can mean the destruction of a fear, a blockage, a wall. The idea of the Tower, if you think the Tower of Babel from the Old Testament, out of hubris, toxic pride, not esteem, hubris, men, scriptural, tried to build this tower to reach God, to reach heaven. In other words, instead of working the divine plan, they were going to be like, no, we're going to do this. Very much an ego-driven thing. Well, they struck it down. God went, poof, in this case, Poseidon, okay? The earth shaker, right? The foundation may be solid, but what was built upon it was not. So that structure had to come down. So this can be a belief system. This can be all sorts of things. But because it's in the physical world, I'm going to kind of guess that your work has been struck by lightning. Maybe it's a lightning bolt of truth, or maybe it's as a result of what's going on economically on planet Earth right now. So did it come as a shock? I feel like if this is October, November, if this has not already been going on for a while, then really try and see it from the larger picture and mother yourself. Like that's one interpretation here. And I feel like that could be for a lot of people. Just a fan. All right. Career. What's going on the inside, right? You've got the student archetype in play. In some way, you've got the Taurus card, right? That life values. And in the outside, we've got Nine of Pentacles. So you've got your own stuff here. You've got your own Nine of Pentacles. I love it. I mean, I want to call that the Virgo card. It's like, God bless the Virgo that has their own, right? Legs crossed. I got my own. It's not the Ten of Pentacles. But it's an awful lot of earth going on here. So in terms of your career, there is definitely, I'm going to say, some fertility here. I'm going to say some, you have what it takes. Even if this is the interior wealth of wisdom, of courage, of fortitude, of clarity, of determination, right? All those soul qualities that very much could be powered by the student archetype. Openness to lifelong learning. If you're like, well, I came into this life, I was sent into this world, into this particular timeline, into this particular body with this personality and these set of ancestral patterns that I'm here to transform. So let's do this. It may be slow going, fixed earth on the inside, but you're going to find what you really, really value. And then I get that Nine of Pentacles that's saying, I know what's important to me. I know what I value. Throw whatever you want. I get to decide, right? It's very much being in power. And again, that Ten of Pentacles, just one more pentacle to go. That's a pretty good journey going on here inside of yourself. I like that a lot. And really trust your creativity in this. You have everything that you need. And this is in the outside world. So it's really saying you're showing your independence and your strength and your fertility. I'm digging this a lot. I'm digging it a lot. Your capability, right? Like people would look at you and go, no, they can. If you want something done, give it to somebody who's busy. If you really want something done, give it to a witch who's busy. Trust and believe. All right. So in your vocation, we have got the Bully archetype with the Three of Pentacles. Again, very earthy read for an air sign. Do check your other signs if they are in. I love this. If they are in earth signs. The outside is the Seven of Blades. A little secret. A little keep it hidden. If you want to keep it. Right. Keep it secret. Keep it safe, right? There's info coming to you from the divine, but on the outside, you're building something. There is a plan. May not have come all the way into the third eye yet, right? That's second level of power. That's when you start sculpting the clay here. Sculpting the clay is actually going on here. The inspiration's there. What's standing in the way? Are you willing to confront your inner fears? I feel like even if there is somebody that's bullying you, or the market is bullying you, bullying market, or just life in general is just terrifying you, confront it inside yourself, right? It doesn't say confront outside fears. It says highlights your tendency to intimidate others, helps you confront the inner fears that bully you. So this might be you bullying yourself, and this new creativity is coming through, and you're not sharing it. Now, I will say, Seven of Swords, a tricky, sticky card. Can be sly, can be cunning. I mean, it's got its positives and its negatives. It's lead and it's gold, like every card in every deck of divination, you could say. But what I'm getting here is that this isn't all just keeping things secret because you've got a creative process going on. You might need a confidant. You might need a confessor. It might be helpful. Now, I do that through prayer. Yes, I have my friends and my collaborators that we have conversations with. Of course, no man is an island, not even a Long Island. To even maybe do that, to bring your fears to the altar of the divine within your eighth chakra, so to speak, and just hand it over and say, all right, what do I got to do? What do I got to do? That this is something about your spiritual path and your vocation here. So putting this all together, we're going to work from the eighth chakra down, right? You've got this bully archetype, but something is forming. There is a good, solid beginning foundation here. And considering that you've got the tower here in the physical world, the world of work, it's okay. The new foundation is being created. There are fears involved there, and I can understand wanting to keep that on the down low somewhat, but also know that this might be as well out of shame. And look, I think we all get a pass this year in terms of things being ripped away from us because nobody saw this fucker coming. Not even I did. I'm not an oracle. I'm a reader. There's a difference. Oracles tend to see things for the whole world, right? More prophecy-based. The Oracle of Delphi did not do soulmate twin flame readings, right? And you just couldn't walk in the door either. You had to be like a king. You had to be like a noble, a somebody, right? A warrior or something. Not everybody got to go see the priestess Pythias of Delphi. So with that energy going on here, coming down through the heart, the crown, the third eye, the throat and the heart. There's a learning process here. Students, something of great value, learning what your true values are, and really on the outside being very strong and stable. So even if you did lose your job or your channel of income, there's only one source of abundance, and that's the divine. But infinite channels we can open up to do that, right? That's part of the creative process as well. But there's something very strong and very stable here in terms of your career. Like whatever it is that you do, regardless of who you do it for or who pays you, that's still active here, but it's still a learning curve. So if you started something in terms of self-employment, right? Or a side gig or something, that's there. And you've got everything that you need in the outside to at least move it to the next stage. So that as it comes down into physical form, though, a drastic change may have taken place or is taking place or will take place. And it does feel like it's going to go pretty quick when it does hit. Earthquakes don't last long. Then really inside of you, if you can hover above, it's like you see the tower coming, and you're just like pull back, see it from the larger picture so that you can really mother yourself, right? Mother others, mother this three of pentacles in the crown all the way down, that you're conceiving it, right? It's gestating, it's growing. You're going to do the labor and give birth, but not just yet. So to be very kind to yourself, right? Nurturance, patience, unconditional love, joy in giving birth to your life. So be very unconditionally loving of yourself as you go through this, as the tower shakes itself out. Really, 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 really great reading, my Libras. So may the Libra collective sun, moon, rising signs be blessed with all that they need. October, November in their work, career, vocation, to mother themselves, to learn and study what they need to study, to confront those inner fears, that they may heal, that they may grow, that they may manifest their very best in their work, career, vocation for their well-being and for the well-being of all. So mode it be. And so it is. Thank you all so very, very much for watching. Again, please do like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Help me reach my goals, and I will keep giving you the very best and the very blessed that I do. Thank you so very much. Otherwise, wishing you the very best and the very blessed of your work, career, and vocation. October, November 2020, my Libra friends, hail, farewell, and blessed, blessed.